Hi everyone, this is S. Luna Yunus, Assistant Professor in the Department of Chemistry. In this video, I would like to discuss electroless plating. So, electroless plating is a very good surface coating method, same as electroplating. Now, in this video, we will see what is electroless plating, why electroless plating is done, and the principle in electroless plating, requirements, and how nickel plating is done by this method, along with the advantages and applications. So, first let's see what is electroless plating. So, electroless plating is a simple deposition technique in which a metal is being coated using a reducing agent. So, the reducing agent will reduce the metal ions to metal and the metal will get coated on the article. So, this is an autocatalytic process. So, one more thing is this method can be used for all type of metals and moreover even complicated parts can be plated by this technique. Okay, so, why electroless plating? So, electroless plating is done mainly to avoid corrosion. So, corrosion is a process in which metals will undergo decay due to certain atmospheric conditions. So, once this process is being done, metals will become resistant to corrosion. So, the surface can be coated either with gold or silver or copper to avoid corrosion. Okay, next one is for aesthetic appearance. Any metal or any article which is subjected to electroless plating will have a better appearance. So, for example, we can consider gold. So, the appearance of an article coated with gold will definitely be better. And third one is to improve the commercial value. Any object which is subjected to plating will definitely have higher market value. So, it enhances the market value of the metal on which it is being coated. And fourth one is to improve the thermal conductivity. So, we know that copper has a very good thermal conductivity. So, if we coat any article with copper, definitely the thermal conductivity will get enhanced. And finally, coming to the tensile strength. So, metals subjected to electroless plating will have better mechanical properties. For example, hardness, tensile strength and so on. So, metals like aluminium and copper have the property of improving the hardness on the object on which it is being plated. Now, coming to the principle of electroless plating. So, the main principle is it requires a reducing agent. So, the reducing agent will react with the metal ions. So, the metal ions will be reduced to the metal along with the oxidized product. So, the metal formed will get coated on the object. So, this is the basic principle involved in electroless plating. So, we will see the steps involved in electroless plating. So, it involves three basic steps. So, step one is pre-treatment or activation of metals. And the second step is preparation of the plating bath. And the third one is the process. So, step one, pre-treatment or activation of metals. So, the metal or the object which is to be subjected to electroless plating should be initially cleaned properly. So, once it is cleaned, it has to be treated with some chemicals. So, this pre-treatment or activation will be different for different metals. So, for example, if we consider stainless steel. So, stainless steel can be subjected to etching using dilute sulfuric acid. So, it purely depends on the base metal by which the article is made of. And second one is certain metals, for example, copper, nickel. So, these metals will be subjected to electroplating initially, after that it will be subjected to electroless plating. And moreover, certain metals, for example, aluminium, copper and alloys like brass, so they do not require any pre-treatment. So, directly it can be subjected to electroless plating. And moreover, non-metals, for example, plastics or glass, these materials can be treated with stannous chloride, dilute hydrochloric acid followed by palladium chloride. So, once this process is done or pre-treatment is done, the material will get or the article will get activated. So second step is preparation of plating bath. So the plating bath will require certain solutions. For example, coating solution is required, reducing agent is required, complexing agent, stabilizer, buffer. All these solutions are required to prepare the plating bath. So we will see the role of each component. So first one is the coating solution. So generally coating solution will be sulfates or chloride salts. So for example, if copper is to be plated or if a copper coating is to be done on some object, copper sulfate can be selected. So based on the coat metal, we can select salt solutions. So that is the coating solution. And second one is an important component, which is nothing but the reducing agent. So reducing agent will reduce the metal ions to metals. So again, the common reducing agents used will be sodium hypophosphite or formaldehyde can be used. And the third one is complexing agent. So complexing agent, so in order to obtain a uniform coating and a coating of very good quality, complexing agent is very, very essential. So for example, the common agent, complexing agents are sodium succinate, EDTA, tartarates can be used. And next one is the stabilizer. So the role of the stabilizer is to avoid decomposition of the plating solution. So it will make the solution stable. So stabilizers can be used. And finally, this process will generally be carried out in the pH range of 4.5. So some acidic buffer can be used. So the common buffer solution used is sodium acetate. Now this table shows the plating bath solutions which is required to coat nickel on the object. So as we saw in the previous slide, coating solution for nickel is nickel chloride. So nearly 20 gram per liter of nickel chloride solution is taken, and to that reducing agent sodium hypophosphite, around 20 gram per liter of sodium hypophosphite is being added. Then complexing agent to get uniform coating, sodium succinate is used, and the quantity is around 15 gram per liter along with the buffer solution. So sodium acetate is taken as the pH is to be maintained at 4.5. And finally, temperature. So temperature is also a very important condition for a good quality plating. So temperature for this nickel coating is 93 degrees C. So once this plating bath is ready, so from this diagram you can easily understand, so the plating bath is ready, and in this the object. So the object is placed inside the solution for a particular period of time. So maybe a few minutes. So after a particular period of time, a uniform layer will get coated on the object. So metal ions plus reducing agent will give metal plus oxidized product. So the metal ions are being converted to metal by the reducing agent, and it will get coated on the object. Now we'll see the reactions involved in this process. So nickel ions from nickel chloride solution, that is Ni2 plus ions, will undergo reduction by gaining 2 electrons. So Ni2 plus plus 2E minus will give Ni. This nickel will coat on the object. And at the anode, the hypophosphite ions H2PO2 minus in the presence of water will be converted to hydrogen phosphate ions H2PO3 minus plus 2H plus plus 2E minus. Now coming to the overall reaction, when we sum up these two reactions, the electrons on both sides will get cancelled. So the overall reaction is Ni2 plus plus H2PO2 minus plus H2O gives H2PO3 minus plus 2H plus plus Ni. So this is the overall reaction. And finally, coming to the advantages. So the main advantages of this process is it does not require electricity. So just by using a reducing agent, this process can be carried out. So we don't need any separate anode or separate cathode in this process. And moreover, one more important point to be noted is complicated parts or intricate parts can be easily coated in this process. And then even non-conducting materials, for example, plastics, glass or ceramics can be also subjected to electroless plating. And finally, this deposit will be very uniform, it will be very hard and it will have an excellent appearance. So, coming to the applications, it has a wide range of applications. It is generally used in automotive parts, for example, in the rims of the car, exhausts, then it is used in valves, gears, and even in some household items, this electroless plating can be used. And moreover, this is very, very common method, which is used to make printed circuit boards, which will have excellent conductivity. Thank you.